In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome to St. Paul Servant Preparation Course. Today we have a talk about the dogma. Our talk for today is salvation in the Orthodox faith. And we're also going to talk about salvation to different Christian denominations and also other non-Christian religion. So let's get started. Dogmatic topic, part 7. Salvation in the Orthodox faith. Objectives for this talk: to review the benefit of the incarnation and the need for a redeemer, to study the criteria of salvation in the Orthodox faith, to view salvation as it is understood in other Christian denominations, and to address the heresy of salvation in one moment. First, let's review sin. What exactly is sin? Sin is disobedience to God and transgression against him, showing our lack of love for him. And because sin was directed toward the unlimited God, sin also become unlimited. That's why the Redeemer also has to be unlimited. And the only one who is unlimited is God himself. So the only choice we have is God himself, the unlimited God, should incarnate, take the human nature, and shed his own blood on the cross for our salvation. So let's review the benefit of incarnation from the last week lesson. First, human salvation, correct the corrupted human nature, show us victory over the devil on the mountain, and showed us the way of virtue and the love for God. Remember, sin led to death. It is written, for the wage of sin is this, Romans 6:23. Based on that, since man disobeyed God and he became a sinner, he came under the punishment of death. So we only have two choices. Either man die, and in that case, God has to create a new creature, or man should live and God redeem him. Let's study these options. First, why man should live? God's love for man is overwhelming. And God blessed Adam and Eve before they sinned. And God's blessing is unchangeable. And don't forget, God's knowledge is perfect from the beginning. And human sin is not a surprise to him. God knew from the beginning, before he hit Adam and Eve, that they will sin and he will come incarnate us and redeem us and take us back to him in heaven. And always remember, God is almighty and capable of everything. Nothing is impossible for God. Even if you think it's too hard, it's impossible that God, who lives in heaven, incarnate and takes the human nature and tolerates the suffering and the punishment on the cross, it's impossible. For God's not impossible. Everything is possible with God. Then if man should live, then a redeemer has to die in his behalf. And this is the idea of the Redeemer. Someone must die on behalf of us to redeem us back to God. Someone also must reconcile us with God. Since there was enmity between God and human, someone has to be Redeemer, reconcile man to God. Someone also must repair the corrupted human nature. Since Adam and Eve sinned, all their nature become corrupted, and their descendant nature become corrupted. And we saw the sin spread through the descendant of Cain until God finally has to destroy the world through the flood. Then what were the criteria of the Redeemer? Must be without sin, which means born without an earthly father. Because everyone who's born from an earthly father is a sinner. The Redeemer should not be born from an earthly father. Must be unlimited, because sin was directed toward the unlimited God. Must take the form of man, because man is sin and the Redeemer should be a man. And of course, he has to die and resurrect. So the only solution is God himself. That's why incarnation was a very important and essential subject for our salvation. If we examine the option that we have on earth, the best prophet like Elijah or Moses cannot be a Redeemer. Why? Because first of all, they carry the original sin. And second, they are limited. If we look to angel or archangel, like Archangel Michael, still he cannot be the redeemer. Why? Because he is limited and he cannot repair the corrupted human nature. So the only available and true option is God himself. God himself will incarnate, take our shape, and redeem us on the cross. Next, we're going to talk about the criteria of salvation in the Orthodox faith. So what exactly salvation mean? Salvation means that you are saved. You are saved from torture in hell. You go to heaven and you enjoy eternal happiness with God, the angel, and the saint. That the word salvation mean. Saved from hell, enjoyed the eternal happiness with God forever. So what are the requirements for salvation? What should you do to be saved? What should you do to go to heaven? First, faith. I'm going to talk about it in detail. Second, redemptive sacrament. There are four essential sacraments for our redemption, which are baptism, confirmation, repentance, confession, and Eucharist. And third, good works or good deed. So three essential criteria: faith, redemptive sacrament, and good deeds. Let's start first by faith. What exactly mean by faith? Could somebody tell you, I have a belief there is God? Is that enough? That's not enough. Somebody tell you, I believe that at one time we all will die. Is that enough? No, it's not enough. Someone will tell you, I believe that we're going to stand before God for judgment at the end of the days. Is that enough? No, it's not enough. What we mean by faith is faith in the blood of Jesus Christ and his sacrifice on the cross. You believe that Jesus Christ is the incarnated God who gave himself a ransom for us on the cross. That's number one criteria of the faith. It is written, without shedding blood, no remission of sins. And all you know, remember the famous verse in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And another time Jesus said to the people, if you don't believe that I am he, you will die in your sins. So you have to believe Jesus Christ, the incarnated God, the Redeemer, the Messiah, and you have to believe in his redemptive sacrament on the cross, which means you have to believe he was crucified. Those who deny crucifixion will never have a chance of salvation. So they said, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved, you and your household. That's what St. Paul said to the people of Philippians. My faith should be a living faith. And this is the third requirement of faith. As we mentioned in the gospel and this our song, amen, amen, amen. Your death, O Lord, we proclaim. Your whole resurrection and ascension into the heaven, we confess. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you, and we entreat you, O our God. So it has to be a living faith, which means faith that we talk about, faith that we preach, and faith that we live by. Redemptive sacrament, the first one, of course, is baptism. As you all know, he who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. This is Jesus' word to his disciple in Mark 16:16. Also, in John 3:3, he said, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot seek the kingdom of God. That in his talk with Nicodemus. So why baptism is very important? Because baptism is basically death with Christ. Death and resurrection with Christ. He died for my sin. I die with him in baptism. Remember St. Peter in his famous speech in Act 2, he said to the believer, repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And all the believer got baptized. Even Saul of Tarsus, when he converted, he was baptized. So baptism is the gate for salvation. As St. Paul wrote to the Romans, now if we died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Romans 6:8. The second sacrament is chrismation or confirmation. And here I'm going to quote part from St. Peter's speech. Repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. So here you talk about baptism and the rest of it, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will receive in chrismation or confirmation. So why is the Holy Spirit is necessary for our salvation? we cannot be saved without the gift of the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is the one who is responsible for all the good deeds that we do. The deeds like repentance, prayer, fasting, humility, service, and so on. The Holy Spirit entitles us to do the good work and to seek repentance. It is the one that entices us to repent and to pray, to get closer to God. And in the beginning of the church, the Holy Spirit was received by laying hands on the believer. But later on, the disciples figure out another way. So they get the spices from around Jesus Christ's coffin and started to add virgin oil and other pure and righteous oil and make it the holy myron. And they will send the holy myron to the believer across the world. As written in Acts 8:17, then they laid hands on them and they received the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one who makes you feel guilty after sinning and encourage you to repent and entice you to get closer to God day by day, by kneeling, by prayer, by reading the Bible. So whenever you feel that you want to spend more time with the Bible or spend more time with the prayer, it is the Holy Spirit that works in you and encourages you to do these good deeds. So basically, separation from the Holy Spirit or denying the work of the Holy Spirit will end up separating you from God and you deny salvation. Next is Eucharist or communion. As Jesus himself said, who eat my flesh, drink my blood, abide in me and I in him. Who eat this bread will live forever. And we take the same part and recite it in the liturgy, as we say, or the priest say, given for the remission of sin and eternal life to those who partake of it. That's why we're always keen to take communion as much as we can. The fourth sacrament is repentance and confession. Since faith and baptism prevent you from sinning again, now whenever we go for sin, we need to be repentant. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all righteousness. God required the repentance of the angel of the churches in the book of Revelation. So repentance is very essential for our salvation. By being baptized, we get rid of the original sin. By taking the chrismation, we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. But later on in life, we will sin. Now we need to wash ourselves again. There is no need for baptism since it was a symbol of Jesus' crucifixion. But now comes the role of repentance and confession. Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sin of any, they are forgiven. And they retain the sin, they are retained. So this Jesus' word to the disciple in John 20. And third is good deed. All the believer has to come up with good deeds or good works. Good work alone are not sufficient for salvation without faith and without redemptive sacrament. Because you always find some non-believer who come up with good deeds, like church work, like mercy act, like helping others. But is that enough? No, it's not enough. The requirement for salvation, as I mentioned, first faith in Jesus Christ and his bloody sacrifice on the cross, second, redemptive sacrament, and third, the good deeds. You all know the verse, the very famous verse in James 2, faith without work is dead. Next, we're going to talk about salvation in different Christian denominations. So for the Catholic Church, it is the same as us. They have the same requirement. For the Protestant Church, they require faith. And some of them may say, oh, we can have a good deed or maybe not. And they only require two sacraments, baptism and communion. For the Methodist and Lutheran, they're the same as the Protestant. For the Amish people, they focus mostly on good deeds and don't mingle with the rest of the world. And that's why they deny taking blood transfusion from other people, because they think the world is sinner, and if they mingle with them, they will receive sin. If we talk to salvation in different religion other than Christianity, start by Mennonites, they basically focus on good deed and faith. Islam only focus on good deed. Hindu, no salvation is required. Buddhism, no salvation needed because of constant process of reincarnation. So in the Buddhism, your spirit will be reincarnated in different body every life. Next, we're going to address the heresy of salvation in one moment. And this heresy came in the late 20th century, basically by the Protestant church, because they try to deny most of the sacrament and the requirement of good deeds. We'll start focus only on faith instead of just believe in Jesus Christ. And they try to take the example of the right side thief and the jailkeeper in Philippi to justify their point. However, that's completely wrong. We respond that, first of all, there are so many good deeds the right side thief made. He believed in Jesus Christ while he was crucified and humiliated on the cross in a situation where nobody could believe in him. Even other people will doubt him. The second, that the right side thief start to confess his own sins and receive the due reward for it. He acknowledged that he's a sinner and he deserved to be put to this, but he justified Jesus Christ and said he is innocent, he is righteous, and he is pure. So he acknowledged his own sin and admit Jesus Christ as an unsinner and start to defend Christ against the other thief and blame the other thief. And finally said to the Lord, remember me when I come into your kingdom. So he had a complete belief in Jesus Christ, that he will be God and he will be the true God in the eternal kingdom. And in terms of baptism, he was baptized with him in blood. As you know, that they broke down the legs of the thieves. So he was baptizing him in his own blood. So this is the objective that we cover for this lecture. We review the benefit of incarnation and the need of the Redeemer from the last lecture. We study the criteria for salvation in the Orthodox faith. We view salvation in different Christian denominations and other religion, and we address the heresy of salvation in one moment by the Protestant church. Finally, I will leave you with some memorization verses. Without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. Hebrews 9:22. If you don't believe that I am he, you will die in your sins. John 8:24. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Romans 6:8. I think we covered the topic of salvation in the Orthodox faith. And again, the most important point is you have to believe in Jesus Christ as an incarnated God, the Messiah, the Redeemer, his sacrifice on the cross. You have to practice the four redemptive sins, the baptism, the chrismation, the Eucharist, and the confession. And finally, you have to come with the good deeds. Good deeds by itself is not enough for salvation for you or any other human being. Thank you so much for your attendance. I'll see you next week in another lecture in the Dogma, and glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.